Hello everyone, this is Neha Wagh, Head and Assistant Professor, Department of Botany at Arts, Science and Commerce College, Ramanandanagar, Burli. At very first, I would like to thank Dr. Humne sir for providing me with this wonderful opportunity to share my knowledge in this 3 days national workshop on CSIR NET, JRF and LS preparation. I also would like to congratulate all the team members of Botany for You for providing this online platform to the students of life sciences. You all have been working so nicely to run this program so efficiently. Thank you everyone and congratulate once again. So this is my brief introduction. I am Ms. Neha Wagh, Head and Assistant Professor, Department of Botany at Arts, Science and Commerce College, Ramanandanagar, Burli, District Sangli. The title of topic is Comparative Account of Mechanism of Carbon Fixation in Plants. This belongs to the unit number 6, that is Plant Physiology of CSIR NET Life Science Syllabus. So let's begin. These are the contents of our discussion. Now, what is photosynthesis? The first question arises in our mind is, what is photosynthesis? It is basically mean the conversion of light energy into chemical energy, or in the broad sense, it is the process in which inorganic molecules like CO2 and H2O get converted into organic molecule, that is glucose, by using chlorophyll and light energy with release of oxygen. Light reaction of photosynthesis, or it's also known as light dependent reaction, as described in name, this reaction depends on light. First of all, let's see the site of reaction. It is a type of plastid named as chloroplast. So this is the structure of chloroplast where the photosynthesis occurs. And inside the chloroplast, there is presence of double membrane structure called thylakoid. And inside the thylakoid membrane where light dependent reaction occurs. So here light reaction of photosynthesis occurs. Specially, these membrane of thylakoid are embedded with specialized light absorbing proteins called photosystems, which make them the site for these kind of reactions. As soon as light is absorbed, the photolysis of water takes place and energy is used to drive electrons from the water to generate NADPH and ATP. At this point, oxygen is evolved from oxygen evolving complex. From light reaction, we get ATP as well as NADPH. ATP gives energy and NADPH acts as reducing agent in Kelvin cycle. In Kelvin cycle, carbon dioxide, which is atmospheric carbon dioxide, is first fixed and then it's reduced into some useful form like glucose, and this glucose is useful in various metabolic processes of plants like cellular respiration, formation of cellulose, formation of starch and other organic compounds. Let's see the first structure of chloroplast. Chloroplast is a double membrane structure, the outer membrane, the inner membrane, thylakoid and the stroma. The stroma is the soup part of the chloroplast where all the enzymes for CO2 fixation are present. The CO2 fixation part of photosynthesis takes place inside the stroma. That means the site for Kelvin cycle is stroma. You can see these are the leaves of plant, and when we take cross section of this leaf, we can see this band of mesophyll cells. These mesophyll cells contain large number of chloroplast, and when we zoom out this chloroplast, we can see the structure like this. This one is double membrane structure. This is outer membrane. This is inner membrane, and the stack of granum is known as thylakoid. These thylakoid are embedded in this stroma, and stroma is the soup part of the chloroplast where all the enzymes for Kelvin cycle are present. The CO2, we recently reviewed the light reaction of photosynthesis that convert light energy into chemical energy such as ATP and NADPH. These occurs in the thylakoid membrane that form pancake-like stack called granum. So these thylakoids are nothing but the stack of granum. And inside this membrane, light reaction takes place where light is absorbed and photolysis of water takes place, and oxygen is evolved through oxygen evolving complex. So oxygen is acts as byproduct of light reaction, or we can call it as a byproduct of photosynthesis. The CO2 fixing or carbon fixing reaction of photosynthesis refers to the synthesis of sugars from CO2 molecule, and these occur in Kelvin cycle. This process is completely catalyzed by enzymes, and these enzymes are present in this stroma. Kelvin cycle takes place inside the stroma, and the necessary enzymes required for Kelvin cycle are present in this stroma. Now, actual photosynthesis occurs in two states. First is light harvesting that converts light energy to chemical energy that are ATP and NADPH. In light reaction, there is splitting of H2O, which produces oxygen as byproduct. Second part is carbon fixing. It uses ATP and NADPH from light reactions to fix carbon dioxide into sugar. Now, C3 photosynthesis and the Kelvin cycle. When plants first appeared in algal form some 2 billion years ago, the kind of photosynthesis process they invented and passed on to the land plant was the C3 process of photosynthesis. Now, what is mean by C3 photosynthesis? The C3 in C3 photosynthesis refers to the first stable molecule formed from an enzyme catalyzed CO2 fixation event. Here, what happens in case of C3 photosynthesis? CO2 is fixed on 5 carbon skeleton, that is RUBP, ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate, by an enzyme Rubisco, and forms 6 carbon compound, which is unstable. So it is breaks into 2 molecules of 3 carbon containing 2 molecules of 3 carbon containing 3 phosphoglycerate. So that's why the name is C3 photosynthesis, because here the stable compound, which is 3 carbon. So that's why the name is C3 photosynthesis, because here first product which was formed was 6 carbon, but it was unstable. So it has to break into 2 molecules of 3 carbon containing compound, that is 3 phosphoglycerate. Hence, the first stable compound is 3 carbon containing. That's why the name is C3 photosynthesis. The Kelvin cycle processes the fixed CO2, some useful form such as sugar, and this sugar is exported to the phloem, and it will be transported to the other part of the plant. Some of the sugar is held back here for resynthesizing the RUBP, so that another round of CO2 fixation can occur. So some of the sugar is exported to the phloem to transported to all the parts of the plant, and some of the sugar will be held back to resynthesizing the RUBP to regulate the another round of CO2 fixation. Now, the major site of control of Kelvin cycle is Rubisco, and it is activated by light. The pH of stroma during night time is 7, and during daytime it is 8, and the optimum pH of Rubisco is 8. Thus, Rubisco is active only in daytime, and it is less active during night time. Rubisco and the Kelvin cycle evolved in the first plant form 2 billion years ago, when there was Earth's atmosphere was about to having 10% of CO2 and 1% of oxygen. So at that time, Rubisco had to fix CO2 and not O2. But after some billions years, when Earth was covered by plants, in this process, the atmospheric level of CO2 reduced to 0.03% and oxygen level increased to 20%. This radical change in atmosphere exposed to design a flaw in Rubisco, and it's hinted by its name, ribulose bisphosphate carboxylase oxygenase. That means Rubisco. The name Rubisco indicates that this enzyme sometimes acts as carboxylase enzyme and sometimes acts as oxygenase enzyme, which fixes oxygen. So sometimes what happens when there was a CO2 level is reduced, or it get reduced to only 0.03%, and when oxygen level is increased, that Rubisco acts as oxygenase enzyme and it fixes the oxygen. Around 30% of time, Rubisco makes the mistake of fixing oxygen instead of CO2, and this is very bad for the plant, because when Rubisco fixes oxygen on 5 carbon containing RUBP, it forms one molecule of 3-phosphoglycerate and one molecule of 2-phosphoglycolate. The plant just consumes oxygen. There is no food value to oxygen, no calories. The molecule that was created from the oxygen fixation, phosphoglycolate, cannot be used in making sugar. It must be replaced or reprocessed into a useful molecule. The plant reprocesses this phosphoglycolate using a biochemical pathway termed as photorespiration pathway. So when Rubisco fixes oxygen on 5-carbon skeleton of RUBP, these will form one molecule of phosphoglycolate and one molecule of phosphoglycerate. But this 2-phosphoglycolate cannot be directly useful in synthesizing of sugar. So it has to be reprocessed to convert it into some useful form. And for reprocessing or to convert it into some useful form, plants have some specific pathway known as photorespiration. Now, what is mean by photorespiration? The respiration that takes place in presence of light, which consumes oxygen and releases CO2. And this process is carried out by Rubisco. The photorespiration pathway is long tortuous circuit that passes through three organelles that are chloroplast, peroxisome, and mitochondria. These are the three cell organelles through which photorespiration pathway is occur. When phosphoglycolate is processed by this pathway, a CO2 is lost from the molecule. So that now not only does the plant not fix CO2, but when it fixes oxygen, it loses an already fixed CO2. Thus, in terms of energy and carbon combined, the net loss to the plant is 40%, and the flaw in Rubisco has caused C3 plants to become 40% less productive. Now there comes C4 photosynthesis. C4 plants perform better than C3 plants in open sunlight environment. C4 plants have evolved a means of suppressing photorespiration and a fixation of O2 by Rubisco. So C4 plants have developed some advanced photosynthetic mechanism that we called as C4 photosynthesis. Here what happens, photorespiration is suppressed because here oxygen is not fixed by Rubisco. So automatically photorespiration will be suppressed in C4 photosynthesis. Now this is the graph showing the rate of photosynthesis and in C3 and C4 plants. This line shows the rate of photosynthesis rate in C3 plant. What happens in C3 plants? The rate of photosynthesis at peak sunlight is less when compared to rate of photosynthesis in C4 plants at peak sunlight. So the rate of photosynthesis will always high in C4 plants. C4 photosynthesis is named so because the first stable molecule formed from the fixation of CO2 is a 4-carbon organic acid, that is oxaloacetic acid. So here in C4 photosynthesis, phosphoenolpyruvate, which is 3-carbon compound, combined with CO2 by the enzyme phosphoenolpyruvate carboxylase to form 4-carbon organic acid, that is known as oxaloacetic acid. So what happens in C4 photosynthesis? CO2 is fixed on this 3-carbon containing compound phosphoenolpyruvate by phosphoenolpyruvate carboxylase enzyme to form 4-carbon organic acid, that is oxaloacetic acid. Now, why there is no photorespiration in C4 plant? Since nature could not fix the flaw in Rubisco, the C4 photosynthetic mechanism moves Rubisco into a part of the leaf where photorespiration will be suppressed. That means C4 plants have evolved their photosynthetic mechanism to suppress the photorespiration. There had been some evolutionary changes in the leaf of the plants. First is, there are two kinds of photosynthetic cells, that are mesophyll cells and bundle sheath cells, which work cooperatively in the process. Second change is that photosynthetic enzymes, some occur in only one cell type and some occur in other cell type. Suppose if in case of mesophyll cell, there is PEP carboxylase which fixes CO2, and in case of bundle sheath cell, the enzyme is Rubisco which fixes the CO2. So here both the cells have different types of enzymes to fix the CO2. Next evolutionary change is that two CO2 fixation enzymes are used in photosynthesis versus one as in C3 plants. Now what happens in C4 plants or C4 photosynthesis, CO2 fixation enzymes are of two types. But in C3 photosynthesis, CO2 fixation was only one, that is Rubisco. And in case of C4 photosynthesis, it is of two type. One is PEP carboxylase, second is Rubisco. So here two enzymes work for the CO2 fixation. Now suppose we have taken the this is the corn leaf cross section, the cross section of leaf of corn. You can see these outer cells are known as mesophyll cells, and inside to these mesophyll cells there is presence of bundle sheath cells, and these mesophyll cell and bundle sheath cell contain different types of two different types of enzymes which fixes CO2. So here this is the evolutionary changes in the plants to suppress the photorespiration. What does they do? They have two types of mesophyll cells, two types of cells. First is mesophyll cell and second is bundle sheath cell, and the CO2 fixation in each type of cell carried out separately because they have separate CO2 fixing enzyme. Now the C4 pathway is a two-part or two-cell processes. Part one, which is occurs in the mesophyll cell, the C4 enzyme located in the cells is PEP carboxylase, that is phosphoenolpyruvate carboxylase, which fixes CO2 onto the phosphoenolpyruvate and forms 4-carbon organic acid, that is oxaloacetic acid. In the second part, this process occurs in the bundle sheath cells, and C4 enzyme located in these cells is Rubisco, which runs the Kelvin cycle. Now in the part one, in this part, that is in the mesophyll cell, CO2 fixation is carried out by an enzyme known as PEP carboxylase. This enzyme fixes the CO2 on phosphoenol pyruvate, which is a 3-carbon compound, and converted into 4-carbon oxaloacetic acid. This oxaloacetic acid is converted into malate, which is also a 4-carbon compound. This PEP carboxylase fixes only CO2 and it never fixes O2. So this happens in mesophyll cell. In the part 2, that is in the bundle sheath cell, whatever the malate is formed in mesophyll cell is transported to bundle sheath cells through plasmodesmata. Now what is mean by plasmodesmata? It is the point from which two cells are interconnected. So this is the plasmodesmata through which two cells are interconnected, and this malate is diffused or transported to the bundle sheath cells from the mesophyll cell. Now mechanism of C4 photosynthesis, or how the C4 photosynthesis takes place, we'll see. The malate which enters into the bundle sheath cells are broken down into CO2 and C3 organic acid, that is pyruvate. The malate which is transported from mesophyll cell into the bundle sheath cell are broken down into CO2 and 3-carbon containing organic acid, that is pyruvate. The subarine layer which is present in cell wall traps CO2 inside the cell, thus it builds up the high CO2 concentration. The subarine layer which is present inside the cell wall, these traps the CO2 inside the cell and it does not allow to pass out the CO2 from the cell. So here CO2 concentration will be high. When CO2 concentration is so high within the cell, Rubisco is swamped with CO2 and it never sees O2. Thus, no oxygen fixation occurs and no photorespiration in C4 photosynthesis. Now there comes CAM photosynthesis. CAM stands for Crassulacean Acid Metabolic Pathway, also known as CAM photosynthesis. What happens in CAM plants? The opening and closing of stomata depends on day and night time. During night time, stomata remains open and CO2 gate enter into the cell, and the CO2 is fixed on 3-carbon compound, that is phosphoenol pyruvate, and forms oxaloacetate. This oxaloacetate is converted into malate. This malate is stored in the form of malic acid in the vacuole. This happens during night time. But during daytime, when stomata remains closed, this malic acid, which is stored inside the vacuole, comes into the cytosol and converted into the malate. Then this malate is broken down into CO2 and pyruvate. This CO2 is fixed in Kelvin cycle and pyruvate is stored as starch inside the chloroplast. This is how the Kelvin cycle runs during daytime also. What happens during daytime? Whatever the malic or malate formed during night time is stored into the vacuole, and when during the daytime, when stomata remains closed, this malic acid come to the malic acid comes into the cytosol and converted into malate. This malate is continuously broken down into CO2 and pyruvate. The CO2 is fixed by enzyme in the Kelvin cycle, and this pyruvate is stored as starch in the chloroplast. So this is how the Kelvin cycle also runs during daytime. In CAM pathway, plants also follows the C4 pathway. When plants follow CAM photosynthesis, they also have to follow C4 photosynthesis. That means here, when CO2 comes inside the cell, that is fixed on phosphoenol pyruvate and form 4 carbon organic acid, that is oxaloacetate. So this is nothing but C4 pathway of photosynthesis. So when CAM photosynthesis takes place in the plants, they have to perform C4 photosynthesis also during daytime. Now this is the comparative overview of photosynthesis in plants according to the leaf structure, efficiency in light, typical habitat characteristics, productivity, optimum temperature. Now in C3 plants and in majority of species, leaf structure contains bundle sheet cells that lacks chloroplast and can be sun or shade plants. It requires relatively moist habitats, and the productivity of C3 plant is moderate, and the optimum temperature for C3 plant is 15 to 25 degrees Celsius. In C4 plants, example are sugarcane and corn, leaf structure is bundle sheet cells have chloroplast and it is ineffective in shade, and it requires arid or tropical region, and the productivity in C4 plant is high, and it requires optimum temperature which ranges from 30 to 40 degrees Celsius. What happens in CAM? The example of cacti comes under the CAM plants. Here, mesophyll cells have large vacuoles and CO2 captures at night. What happens in case of CAM plants? CO2 captures at night time because stomata remains open at night. It requires arid environments, and the productivity of CAM plants is low, and it requires optimum temperature of 35 degrees Celsius. So these CAM plants follow the modified version of C4 pathway, but the difference is in the C4 pathway, there is compartmentalization because few part of the step completed into the mesophyll cells and few part completed into the bundle sheet cell. While in CAM plants, there is no compartmentalization, but malate is stored in the vacuole of plant cell. In any situation, if CO2 is good enough and temperature is optimum, then C3 pathway is the best possible pathway for plant to produce sugar. So the plant always go for C3 pathway. But if there is less concentration of CO2 and there is high temperature, in those cases, plants opt for C4 and CAM pathway. So that in the sense, these are the comparative differences between carbon fixation of C3, C4 and CAM plants. Dear students, if you have any queries regarding to this topic, you can find me at sneha511995@gmail.com. This is my email address, and my mobile number is 9850806050. Best luck for your examination. Thank you for your patience.